Hey guys, Robey here with Divi Engine. And as you know, if you've not been living underneath the rock for the last year, Divi 5 is finally here as a public alpha. So bear that in mind as we go through this. I am very excited to kind of do my first impressions. I have not installed the alpha whatsoever. I have poked around with the Divi dev beta, but not the alpha yet. So this is going to be my first impressions, and I'm going to be doing a couple of things to compare the speed between Divi 4 and Divi 5. Now, I did want to make a mention of the compatibility with Divi Engine plugins. These plugins will not work in Divi 5 right now. We have opted out of the public alpha only for the simple reason so that we can focus our time on dev for Divi 5 instead of answering questions about Divi 5 in the form of things like support tickets and whatnot. Now, we did show you guys our progress with Divi 5 about a month ago in our third dev letter, where Peter walked us through Divi Ajax filter and showing the snappy features within that. And then also, he took a look at the backwards compatibility in Divi 5 with the dev beta. Now, not the alpha. Now, you won't be able to use our plugins with the public alpha. Again, you'll get a message, and I'll probably put it up here on the screen somewhere, that will let you know that we are not opted into that program. Anyway, so why don't we get started? I'm going to take a look right from the installation process all the way through to building some pages, playing with the theme builder, and even inspecting some of the code. So let's take it away. Okay, so here I've got one of my two identical sites on which I'm going to be doing my testing. This is my Divi Alpha one. So why don't we get started with the installation process? So we'll just head over to my theme installer. I'll say add, and then I'll say upload. And then let me just get my file here. And you can download Divi 5 Alpha, of course, directly from Elegant Theme. So let me see what happens when you hit the install. I've never done this before. So let's see. There we go. Okay, so installing this file, it gives you all the information. This theme is already installed. And I'm just going to tell it, well, I'm going to replace it with the uploaded version. And this is, of course, because I already had the V4 installed on here. Okay, great. Now, let me go to the themes. I had a child theme active, so I'm curious to see whether that's going to cause any issues. Does not seem to have. Let me just go to the front end. Okay, so here it says backwards compatibility mode enabled. And what that's telling me is that it's looking at a page with Divi 4 shortcodes on it and not the new Divi 5 way of doing things. But that's very interesting to see that you've got this notice up here that lets you know that that's what you're doing, but the page seems to be working fine. I'm curious to see. Let's enable the editor and see what that does. Okay. Looks like everything is in here. It loaded very nice and quickly. And you can see all the editing options in here. You still got your design tabs, advanced, and all that fun stuff. So far, so good. So that's been pretty painless. And you can kind of see how your existing pages will look in Divi 5. And oh, that's cool. The light and dark mode toggle up here. Kind of dig that. Very exciting stuff. Cool. Okay. Well, I'm going to exit this now. I'm going to discard and exit. It's very snappy. That's the first thing that I'm noticing here, that it's moving nice and quick. And it was kind of the same experience we had with the dev beta that we're playing with right now. Okay, so why don't we just go to the dashboard again quickly? And I want to kind of see here what is happening here. So you've got the Divi 5 Migrator in here. And maybe we'll test that a little bit later once we've played around with it. And then we can see how it works. So here is one module that it will migrate to Divi 5 format. And I would assume it's that page we just looked at. Let's actually do this right now. So let's see what happens here. So migrate this site to Divi 5 Alpha. Okay. Let's confirm that. And is that all done? Rerun Divi 5 compatibility check. Congratulations, yada, yada. Okay, cool. Well, let's go look at that page again on the front end. And it broke. So there you go. The Divi 5 migrator not working fantastically because I think all I had on there was a normal module, a full screen header module, I think. Let's go back here. It did give me the option to reset. I don't want to do page settings. Let's exit the folder here, discard. And let's go back and back and back. Divi 5 Migrator and restore my Divi 4 content. And then let's go see again. Okay, my content is back here. And again, you know, if we look here, what's on this page? What module is this? It is just a simple row with a column and then a text module, it seems. Let me see if I can activate the module layer view. There we go. Yeah, so it's just a column with some text, but somehow that broke in Divi 5 mode. Very interesting observation there. When it migrated, it completely destroyed what I had. Oy. Okay, tough start, tough start. But anyway, cool. Let's go back to my backend. So let me just exit this, discard and exit. Here we go. Okay, so I'm going back to the Divi 5 settings and now going to the dashboard here. It gives you all the information. That's fun. Theme options. Now you can see there's been a slight redesign here. It's a little bit cleaner. You can actually clear the cache from here, which I think is a good addition. But overall, I'm going through here. I'm not seeing any real changes as far as what's available to you. Oh, it's got the SEO stuff. Yeah, nothing really interesting to report here. You can roll back. Cool. Well, lesson over, right? No. Let's dive a little bit deeper here. Let's quickly take a look at the role editor. That's kind of the same deal that we've always had. And the theme customizer, just out of curiosity, you've just got the same settings and stuff in there. Okay, well, cool. That was educational, if anything. So why don't we start by building a page in Divi 5, something simple. And take a look at how fast it is. And we'll replicate that in Divi 4. So I'm going to add a new page. I'll say my Divi 5 page. Simple, use the builder. Wow, that is fast. That it's really nice to see it go that quickly. And then let's select just a single row. Let's add an image to the row. And then here, of course, I can select the image. This is so snappy. I'm loving it. We'll just use that image. And there we have some nice full things. You can set the background color. Let's go here. So it really focuses on the hierarchy here. It's very easy to see that. I like that a lot. Makes it nice and easy to know what's happening. We can force full width on the image. All the settings here, but it's just cleaner. It's not as clunky as it once was. Let's put some shadow on there. Why not? Great. Okay, so let's go and add a heading module. And we'll say my fancy heading. And of course, if I can not hit my spacebar, that'd be great. Okay, cool. And let's add something. Let's add some animation for this. Animation style, we'll just have it bounce in. Cool. Okay, well, that's simple enough. And let's add a new section. Let's see what happens here. If I say full width section, and we'll do a full width header. And it didn't like that. Interesting. So let's look at my layer here, but it is there. Full width header. And then we'll just say full width title, I don't know. And let's go back to the visual mode. I can figure that out. Yep. It does not like the full width header. Okay. Well, there you go. There's one little funky thing that we found. Oh, there it is now. Okay. I see what's happening here. When you click on the layer, it'll actually highlight only that item. So that's interesting. But why can't I scroll? That's still a little bit weird, isn't it? Let's click here. Still can't scroll. So this is a little bit buggy when you add this full width header in here. When it's gone, it's still buggy. Fancy. Okay. Let's see if saving the page fixes that. Let me publish the page. And let me exit.
And there it is. There's my fancy title coming in. When I look at this, now it seems to be fixed again. I wonder if it's isolated to the layers here. I do this. Click on that. No, it works fine. I don't know. Something with adding that full width section with the full width header gave it a heart attack. So easy to see that this is still a alpha and that some things will and can go wrong. Cool. Okay, well, I'm happy with that. This is a good first test. So why don't we try the same thing in Divi 4? So I'm going to go ahead and bring up Divi 4. All right, so here's my Divi 4. We know it is Divi 4 because if I go to Appearance, I've got it right here. And Divi 4.27.1. Okay, so let's do the same thing. Let's go and add a new page. And I'll say my Divi 4 page. And we'll use the Boulder. And, oh, yeah, I actually didn't even notice that this didn't pop up in the Divi 5 version. So that's very interesting. And then we'll go and we'll add an image again. And we'll just select the same image and I'll upload that. Great. And then we'll do a title or heading, right? And my fancy heading. We'll give it that animation. Now, one thing that I really kind of like about the Divi 5 interface is the fact that it's got this sidebar here. I never figure out where this thing's going to pop out. And I know that you can mount it to the side like that, but even that I don't love as much as that clean interface for Divi 5. So that's very positive. What did I do? I added animation. We'll say bounce, and there you go. And just for posterity, let's see if this can handle a full width header. And fancy title. And let's go down and see here. It works fine, it seems. Let's just, for fairness, activate the layer. That one, the layer view, which is here. And yeah, we've got the layer view and it still works fine. So that's definitely something relating to some sort of bug with that Divi 5 interface. So I'm just going to go ahead and publish this. Cool. And yeah, it's not as snappy as Divi 5. And this is, of course, on a local machine. So it does appear to be working fairly stably. I didn't have the double load, which Divi is, of course, very notorious for. But we didn't see that on the Divi 5 version either. Let me exit this page here. Okay, so now what I want to do, I'm here back on my Divi 5 site. I want to go into the theme boulder and kind of see how things operate within that. So I'll come to the theme boulder, that loaded nice and fast. And I've got a bunch of posts already created on here. So let's go ahead and say all posts. So that single post page, let's create a template for that. We'll go in here, we'll say build a custom body. Oh, I was ready to wait to put the load and there it is already. That's awesome. Okay, so let's go ahead and add a row and then we'll just go with a heading and we will use Divi dynamic data that's still in there. So let's delete that out and go here and then I'll go with the post title and apply that. And then let's add an image or the featured image, of course. So let's go ahead and say, okay, well, site logo, oh, featured image, I'm blind. Okay, great. Now, this particular post might not have a featured image, so just keep that in mind. So let's go and add then the content, the post content, there we go. And all the wonderful post content will be there. Okay, so let's go ahead and save this. This is so much faster. Save that, already done. And then if I go to my posts here and I right click and view one of these, here we go. It's got that layout pulled in. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. So I have to admit, I paused there because I wasn't sure why my layout didn't take. And I'm guessing the theme builder is not fully ready in this alpha. And again, you know, like another reason why you're not upgrading or updating to this alpha version with any type of production site. I find it interesting that it didn't work, but it did not work. So let me come back here, and I'm curious to see in the migrator. It says all body templates are compatible with the V5 alpha. It says everything is good to go, but it did not work. So there you go. Maybe that's a bug. Maybe that's something to do with my local setup, but it does not work for me. And that is annoying. I wish it did. But anyway, so let's not stop there. Let's do one more thing here. And what I want to do is go back to the theme builder. Let's see if we can get a global header to work. Just do something simple with the robe. The menu module, and we'll just use that one and as a logo. Okay, that button's not working. More bugs. There you go. Let's see if I can add a search icon. Okay, that worked. And if I wanted that search icon to be a different color, let's see your icons. Yeah, I'm gonna just make it red. That worked. Let's exit that. Let's save our changes. Let's come back here and let me refresh the page. And that seemed to work just fine. So that is odd that this body for the single post page template that I built is not working. But hey, this is all a beta, or not even beta, alpha, right? So there is still some issues with that. Now, I was curious to see maybe whether we can try and install one of our plugins and what it would say. So let me go ahead and do that. And let me just find one here. And drag that up here. Install. See what happens. It will actually let you install it. Let's activate it. And there you go. So it will give you this message that says, this plugin can't be activated because we, Divi Engine, have opted out of the public alpha so that we can focus, of course, on the dev for this. So it doesn't mean that we're not preparing for it. We absolutely are. We are actually very hard at work at getting all this stuff ready. So just hang tight. When we're ready, we're going to start including our plugins with these. But for the time being, you're going to have to wait, unfortunately. And a lot of devs have chosen to do this because, of course, it's very resource intensive to support that stuff, and you know, as well as continuing dev on the V5 versions, because it's an entirely new plugin that we have to create. So that is all the fun stuff with that. But you know, hopefully you guys got to see here a little bit that the V5 alpha is extremely snappy and it works to a degree, but it's certainly not ready for any production site. So I'm definitely going to continue and echo that you guys should not be upgrading at this time, but definitely get in there, kick the tires a bit, find a bunch of bugs like I just did. I am very excited and optimistic for the future of Divi 5 and what it's going to be bringing. I know that we are having a lot of fun with converting our plugins and adding a little bit of like functionality here and there with the freedom that Divi 5 has granted us. And we'll continue releasing these dev letters that are going to keep you in the loop of what we are up to and how we are progressing towards Divi 5's official release. So guys, that was just a quick run through. I will probably do a lot more content on this type of stuff in the future, but I wanted to throw this out there and just give it a whirl and see how it actually also differs from the dev beta that we have. So guys, with that, this has been Robey with the Divi Engine team. Like, subscribe, comment, ask questions. I am going to see you in the next video. Bye for now.